Hi, my dear student friends. Today I am going to explain the concept of constructors for the second year CAC students. The topic is constructors in the unit of third. Okay, here you need to know what is constructor. What is the definition of constructor? Here, in a Java, constructor is a block of code similar to the method. Constructor is a block of code. Block of code means what, ma? This is a block. Here we are writing some code. This is called as a block of code. Constructor is a block of code. It is similar to a method. And it is a special type of method. Constructor is a special type of method which is used to initialize the objects. Which is used to initialize the objects. It is called when an instance of class is created. At the time of calling constructor, the memory is allocated for the objects in the memory location. Okay, na? These constructors, when we create these constructors, means when we call these constructors, when we are creating instances for a particular class. Okay. While calling these constructors, the memory is allotted for the particular objects in a memory location. That is a constructor. What is constructor, ma? In a Java, constructor is a block of code is similar to a method. But constructor is not a general method. It is a special type of method. Okay, it is used to initialize the objects. These constructors are called when you are creating instances for a particular class. While calling these constructors, the memory is reserved or allotted for a particular objects in a memory location. That is called a constructor. So we want to create a constructors, we need to follow some rules. These are the rules we need to follow. First one, constructor name equal to class name. The second rule is constructor does not or doesn't have any written value. Written value or written type. Any written value or written type. Okay. These are the two rules we need to follow while creating a constructors. Okay. First rule, constructor name equal to class name. So whatever the class name we are given, that is used for the constructor. We are not using the different name for the constructor. We need to give the same name of the class name to the constructor. The second one, constructor does not have any written type or any written value. Written type A means suppose we need to remember the functions concept. We are using different types of function categories. Okay, na? No written type, yes written type, no arguments, yes arguments, no written type, no arguments, yes written type, yes arguments, like this. We have to remember the concept. Okay, na? For example, in C, especially in C, we are using the written type like int add or void swap. So means what? We are performing a method or function, that is addition function. So we are using some arguments here by using some data type int x comma int y, whatever it may be. We are using two variables. These two variables are both integer type. But after performing these two variables by some operation, some function, that is addition function, we will get the result that is in the form of also integer type. Okay, na? That is, but the constructor doesn't follow any return type or return value. We are not using any return values. These are the two rules we need to follow, must and should. Generally, we want to create an object or we want to create a constructor, we are following some syntax. That is class name, object name, equal to new constructor. New constructor. Okay, this is the syntax we are using to create the object. This is the syntax for creating an object. Create an object. Okay, this is a class name. Class name, object name is equal to new constructor. So already we know what is new. New is a keyword. So new is a keyword. It is used to create an object. Create an object or instance. Create an object or instance. So this is a constructor. This is a constructor. This constructor is used to initialize initialize a object. Okay, now this is a syntax for creating a object or create a constructor to initialize the object. Okay, now by for example we are taken class name is a student, S is capital. For class name always starts with the capital letter. Student is the class name. Object name is a S. A new. So constructor is what now? What is the first rule? What is the first rule? While creating constructor, you need to remember. What is the first rule? Constructor name is equal to class name. What is class name, ma? Class name is student. So we need to use the same name, student. Okay, this is the example to create the syntax and example for creating an object or constructor. So generally the constructors are two types. Generally the constructors are two types. First one, default constructor. Default constructor. The second one is parameterized constructors. So these are the two types of constructors we are using regularly. The first one is default constructor. The second one is parameterized constructors. Okay, this is the syntax of creating an object. So So this is a class name, this is the object name, this is equal to new, this is the keyword, it is used to create an object. Now just to create an object. So constructor, constructor is for initializing an object. So I will clearly explain with a small program. Then we can create the main method is public static void main. So we can open the main method. Here we need to create an object. In the main method we need to create an object. So what is the syntax for creating an object? Class name. What is our class name? Ma? Student. Student. Okay, class name and object name. What is object? We have to take any object name. S1 equal to new constructor. What is the constructor? Class name is also a constructor name. Student. Student. So then system dot out dot println. So here we are print the names. What is that? We are using the object. What is the object? S1. We already have created an object. So what is the object name? S1. S1 name. S1 roll number. So then we can close the main method, then we can close the class. Okay, this is a small program I want to explain you. So here we are creating a class with the name of the student class we are creating. Okay, here in this class we are creating a instances of a particular class. Okay, now what are the instances? These two are the instances of a particular class. Instances. These are the instances of a particular class. Okay, now. So, this is the constructor. Here we are creating a constructor. So, what is the constructor name? Student. Why? What is the second rule? The class, the constructor name is equal to class name. So what is our class name? Student. So same we are using to create a constructed with the student. Okay, then we are open this constructor. So in this constructor we can initializing. What is the use of constructor? Ma, constructor is used to initializing an objects. So already we know the syntax of initialization. So this is what, ma? Name is a variable. So name is equal to Rama and roll number equal to 520. We are initializing the values to a particular instances or objects. Okay, this is the use of constructor. Already I told this. What is a constructor? Constructor is a block of code. Similarly, a method. It is a block of code. Okay, now this portion is called what, ma? Block of code. Block of code. So then we are open the main method, public static void main. So in this main method we are creating an object. So this is an object we are created. This is an object. So this is a class name. What is the class name? Student. So class name, object name. What is object name? We are using the object name is S1 is equal to new. New is the keyword. What is the purpose of new? So creating an object or instance. So this is the constructor. So what is the use of constructor? It is used to initialize the values. So then we are printing that particular instances or objects. System dot out dot println. S is capital, ma. System dot out dot println. So what is our object name? S1. S1 dot name. So S1 dot roll number. So according to this code, what is the expected output? So here we are getting output. So according to when you are executing this program, the compiler entered into the compiler is also called as a controller. The controller enters into the particular block. Then it will identify, okay, these are the instances of a particular class. They are creating a class. In the class, they called a constructor. In the class, they called a constructor. In this constructor, they are initializing the variables. Then it will going to print our results and run our, execute our results. It will enter into the main function or main method. Then it will check the object, construct or object creation. So then it will check. Okay. Then when the controller enter into this particular instruction, when the controller enters into the particular instruction, it will observe where that the constructor is created. This the constructor is created or not. So then it will go and take this particular block and execute this particular block. So automatically when the constructor come to this instruction, it will checks or identify the particular block, constructor block. Then it will execute according to the particular initializing of your objects. So for this, we will get the results. Rama. So what is the name? Rama. What is the roll number? 520. According to this program, we will get the this result. So for example, suppose I am not, I will put this into the comments. You know that what is this symbol? So when we put these comments, so this particular instruction is not validated, is not executed by the compiler. So when I am not using this particular constructor, so what is the output we will get? We have to identify, guess. So how we will get, ma? So without constructor, it will not initializing the values first of all. Only when it is initializing, it will come to this particular point. It will comes here. It will identify there is no constructor. So automatically it will gives the results the null. The null. Null means what, ma? Zero. Null means what? Zero. Okay, now why? Because when the controller comes here, it will check. So this is student is a constructor. It will automatically go and enter into a particular class where we created a constructor. Why? The constructor is called when we are creating the instances. So there is no constructor. So how it will take? So there it will not initializing taking any values. So automatically it will gives a null value. Null means what ma? Zero value. So when we create these constructors according to like this, so while calling this constructor, we are initializing the objects. While calling this constructor, this is a called one. While creating instances, the constructor will be called. Already it is called. So we want to initializing the object, we are calling the constructor. Okay, now this is what a block of code. So this is used to initialize the object. Initialize the objects. Okay. So are you observe the changes between the two programs? When I using this constructor, when I am not using this constructor, which type of outputs we will get according to that? Okay, now this program is an example for first type of constructor. How many types of constructors we there? We are having two types of constructors. What are those default constructors? The second one is the parameterized constructors. This program is an example for default constructor. Going to explain the parameterized constructor with an example. So the second constructor, this is the second constructor. So student with the parameter, that is parameterized constructor. String str comma int n. I am using this. So open this block. So here name equal to str small case, the objects str, and roll number equal to n. Okay, so we are using this thing. Then I am opening the main function. So public here I am passing the arguments. I am passing arguments. That why we are using string args. String args. So open the main function. Then in the main function we need to create the objects. So you have to remember the syntax always to create the object. So the what is the class name? Student. So object is the first one, S1 is the new, student, then second one, the class name is same as student, the object name is S2. I am using two students, S1 and S2. The keyword is new, then constructor. Then we need to print this particular values or objects. Public static void. So here I am using this S2, but I am not give a particular, I am not initializing the objects here. According to this, here I need to write the particular parameters. What are those parameters? First one is the string, second one is the number. So here I am going to give the name and roll number. Name is Sita. So Sita is a string. That's why we need to enclosed with the double quotes always. The strings always be enclosed with the double quotes. Then second one is what ma? Number. What is number? Roll number. The roll number 506. Maybe it is 506. You have to take like this here. So first one is just here we are initializing them. The second one just we are give the instances, but you are not initializing that objects. That's why here directly we are initializing while creating an objects. Then we are going to print system dot out dot println. So first one, what is the first object? S1. So what is the variable name? S1 dot name. Second one, I am following this as it is. We need to S1 dot, so name and roll number, R number. The second one, third one, S2. Second, what is the second variable object name? S2. S2 dot name. Then S2 dot roll number. Name and roll number. So this is, then we can close the main method and we can close the class. So this is another program. In this program, I want to explain you two types of constructor, default constructor or parameterized constructor. So here, when the controller comes into the class, so it will enter into the constructor. So in this first constructor, it will go and search this particular initialization. So the constructor initializing the object is used to initializing an object. So then the controller enter into the main function. So here we are using the second constructor. But the second constructor is what ma? This is the parameterized constructors. What is parameters? Parameters are nothing but we are arguments or variables. Parameters are nothing but what ma? Arguments or variables. These are the two arguments we are passing here. So that is a parameterized constructor. Here we are not passing any arguments or any parameters. This block is called default constructor. This block is a default constructor. Default constructor. So this block, so we need to continue this part. This block is called parameterized constructors. Parameterized constructor. Why? Because we are using the parameters in a particular constructor. Okay. Then when the controller comes into the main block or main function, it will identify this particular. Here we are creating an object. When it will comes to the this instruction, so it will checks the constructor. It will checks for constructor. Automatically the constructor enter into the class, then it will identify the constructor, then automatically it will call this particular block of the constructor. So then the controller enter into this instruction. So this is a here we are creating the second object along with the parameters. So what are those? Directly we need to write this here. So Sita and 506, these are the parameters of it. Then it will go and execute the first one. So automatically here when the constructor or controller comes here, so it will take this one, Sita, automatically this value is going to initialize in a particular str. Here it will go and initialize. So when it will take this roll number 506, automatically this number go and store here on initializing here. So what is str? The name equal to str. What the str contain? The str contain Sita. The str is already initializing with Sita directly. So what n contains? The n is initialized with 506. Now, so whatever the values is already initialized in a particular parameters, those are going to initialize to the particular name. So now, what is the name? Name is Sita. So what is roll number? Roll number is 506. So then automatically it will go under the compiler, go and initialize the particular parameters. Then it will go and print each and every object. So first one, system dot out dot println s1 dot name. Second one, s1 dot roll number. So next one, s2 dot name, s2 dot roll number. So what is the output according to this one? So when the controller execute this, we will get the result Rama. When it will go and execute this, print this statement, we will get the result. What is that roll number? 510. So then it will comes to this instruction. It will print the s2 dot name. What is the s2 dot name? Sita. Sita. Next, then the controller comes here and execute and print this statement. So what is this statement? So roll number. What is the roll number? 506. Now we will get the result. Rama. Roll number is 10. So names s2 object name is Sita and roll number is 506. This is the output according to our program. Okay. In this program is an example for both constructors. Object default constructors and parameterized constructor. This block is called default constructor. This block is called parameterized constructors. So when we creating a constructor, we are writing the parameters along with this. That constructor is called as a parameterized constructor. When you are not using these parameters while creating a constructor, that is called default constructor. The first program is a direct example for default constructor. In this program, I am explaining both default constructors and parameterized constructors. Are you understood, all of you? So what is constructor? So I hope all you have understood that. So according to my lecture, you need to prepare the notes regarding to constructor. In the next class, I am going to explain the method overriding. Thank you, one and all.